Hello everybody, my name is Shane Sink and I'm selling my 1973 Winnebago Indian that has a Cummins swap. To cut to the chase, for those that are interested but don't want to pay this price, it is $10,000. I need $10,000 out of this. I have so much more money invested into this project. Some of y'all who do build custom vehicles will understand a ton of money has been spent on this, but I'm going to make it worth y'all while. My loss is your gain, yada, yada, yada. And sell it for $10,000. It is a very great vehicle and it's very unique and interesting. It has a Cummins swap done to it. Sorry, I just ran over here and I'm trying to get this done really quick because it's about to rain. This is my only chance to get it done because it's going to rain all week. But Cummins swap, 6BT VE pump Cummins. I did all the work. It is phenomenal, strong, and dependable. Cut to the chase. I'm going to go front to the back, underneath, and then we're going to go inside, then to the roof. Hopefully before it rains. New trans cooler, new intercooler, AC condenser, new radiator. Everything works, no leaks. This isn't hooked up. The compressor is in, though. I plan to run a vintage air unit under the dash. Obviously never got around to it. It was on the last of my priority list. New rebuilt HE351 turbo. All the piping is ran, cold side, hot side, intake side, everything. Hoses. I do need to wire up a voltage regulator back for the alternator. I had to steal it for another project. Y'all know how that goes. Another look at the cold side. Of course, this is a 6BT 12 valve Cummins. VE pumps right there. I did turn up the pump. It does smoke a little bit, but you can easily turn that down. And I also have a fuel pin to throw in with it. I haven't done any modifications other than turning up the pump. For power steering, all you need, this is not done, is a metric adapter and a standard fitting. Take it to a hose shop, get them crimped. For the pressure side, return side, super easy. Just hose clamp it to the pump. There's the vacuum pump right there. I have a new hose going to the hydrovacs in the back. Just put a hose clamp on that real quick. New brake hoses for the front, and the brakes have been redone by the previous owner. I put a new master cylinder. Those are incredibly rare. I think I got the last one left in the country. I have that panel. You just gotta cut wood out and slap it under there. I didn't do it because I was gonna work on the power steering and stuff, and I wanted to be able to reach it easily. But again, an easy fix. Let's see, the wipers work. New lights on the top, new mirrors. The glass is not cracked. A little delamination here, but I mean, it's a 50-year-old Winnebago, so it's still good. I do have new batteries. Honestly, I think these are 2 years old, actually, so they're not really new. New batteries, so it cranks up good. I got a new gray water tank. Yes, gray water, and only gray water because it is a composting toilet. Another thing that'll scare people away, but I think they are great and very useful. Brand new hydrovacs. These are not for a Winnebago. These are actually for a Ford, but all the dimensions, the bore size, the hose size and everything were all the same. It was just the bracket, so I welded them straight to the frame. A new drive shaft. There's a 47 RH transmission. Now, that is heavily built. That is $2,100 right there, just for the rebuild alone, only in the transmission. Very dependable, and you know people ask like $2,000 for a Cummins motor. I'm not factoring that into the price, but I did buy a whole truck for the donor of this, and I'm going to be straightforward. I paid $1,800 for the donor truck. I did part it out and made, you know, about $1,000 back on it. You know, second-gen Dodges aren't really the best, and this one wasn't in good shape, but it did have 189,000 miles on it, and I drove and I put an extra 5,000 miles on it, not on top of the 189, to be sure that it was a good drivetrain. It was a registered insured truck. I drove it for several months in order to have that good assurance that it was a good motor and transmission. But that motor, that transmission is heavily built with a billet converter, extra clutches in the overdrive pack, and obviously I lowered the transmission mount, and you can see you have plenty of transmission or plenty of room for the front axle and the oil pan. You have to flip it, and so it's a new gasket on the oil pan, new gasket on the timing cover. The killer dowel pin has been secured. Other than that, good transmission, beautiful transmission. Refurbished fuel tank. I did that with the Eastwood kit you can get from their fuel tank kit. This is a tankless propane water heater. I forgot the company, starts with a G, but it's all brand new. Looks great. You need a generator plate to put this puppy, put a generator in this puppy. Ah, I turned it the wrong way. I'm trying to hurry up. It has this nifty little rack on the back. It's pretty cool. I have two original taillights to throw back. This one has a hole in it, and that one's not the original light. A rack, it's pretty cool. Ladder, you need to replace the lights on top. I haven't gotten to that yet. Let's see, that's for the propane tanks. It does have two propane tanks, and they still have propane in them. So you know the system doesn't leak. I don't think I've turned them off because I had to test the refrigerator, and the refrigerator works. Refrigerator's right here. And it's a newer refrigerator. I don't know the year or when it was made, but it is a Norcold that it is digital. Here's the exhaust, fully ran to the front. A new fuel cap and filler deal. Now we're gonna go inside. That hasn't been replaced. It's kind of iffy, but I put some sheet metal aluminum right here. It looks pretty spiffy. Gray, that's my color of choice. For the front here, under dash AC if you want it. I wanted it, you don't have to. You need carpet up here. I do have the front seats, the original seats. There's just a couple of cracks in them, but they're actually in really, really good shape. I do have the seats. To the motor here, obviously, 12 valve. Got some wiring here. That's a Volvo fan control. That's a Lincoln Mark 8 fan, the best fan on the market. That is not wired up, but there's schematics and how-tos on the internet. Excuse me. All right, now we're gonna crank it up real quick just so you can see. Easy day. My boss doesn't know I'm out here, so keep it a secret. Let's see, you got fuel level. I don't know if that's calibrated correctly, but it is wired up. Oil pressure, temp, volts, trans temp, and your EGT gauge. Very important with the diesel, and a boost gauge. I know that doesn't match, but it's the only analog 60-pound boost gauge I could find, because my other 12-valve makes, you know, 55 pounds of boost. This doesn't, but, you know, you never know. Let's see. These are your two switches for your torque converter, your overdrive and your torque converter lockup. That's a digital satellite speedometer. I've read good reviews about it, and I can't remember if I wired that correctly. Your lights, your rear wiper and your front wiper right there. This did have an overbed in it, and I took that out. I was just going to put a TV up here and stuff. These nice, nifty little lights right here. I got two of them on each side. They look pretty nice. Now, it is spotty work, but I haven't done my touch-up and stuff, but it is in pretty decent shape for a 50-year-old Winnebago that some schmuck put together. Not that I'm a schmuck. I've been building custom vehicles for 10 years now. But this is it. I made that top. There's the original cushions that I dyed black. Butcher block countertop. The original sink with a faucet I just grabbed off eBay. This is my boost leak tester. I'll throw this in for free. This is worth about $500 on eBay, but you know, you can have it. I'm just kidding. That was a joke. Haha. Nice LED lights. Everywhere. Everywhere. We got one under there. You got one under there. This is a brand new vent right here. This is the original stove. Now, I've tried different colored paints, but I can't get this to finish correctly. So far, this is holding up, but you can see it's a little spotty right there. Y'all can probably figure something out with that, but I could not. Because it's porcelain coated, and I couldn't get anything to stick to it. I sandblasted it and everything. I don't want to take a grinder to it, because that'll make an uneven finish. But subway tiles. Excuse me, it's dusty in here. I'm gonna throw in this microwave because I think my other RV is gonna have a microwave in it. And here's that fridge. Excuse the paint. Again, I haven't done my touch-up stuff. It is a Norcold. It's digital. I don't have it cut on right now. I have a switch for that. But it doesn't stink. Nice and clean. I know it works. I accidentally let it sit on over a weekend, and my bad. Here's the bathroom. Now, this might scare some of y'all. I'm not a bathroom guy, but that's another thing. Oh yeah, I know that's sloppy, but I wanted to keep this completely sealed, and this is a brand new air conditioner. I forgot to mention that too. Brand new Dometic air conditioner. It's got like a billion BTUs. I forget. I think it's like 1,300, 1,500 or something like that, but it is really big and it's very nice. This is aluminum sheet metal. I actually did everything in aluminum sheet metal, but it looked horrible, so I just left this one spot. Aluminum shower rack. That's the poo-poo pipe for the vent of the this and the gray water tank. You got your little fan. You got to put an inlet in here. I was, so that it didn't suck up moist air from a shower or something. This is right here. $1,100 toilet. This is a Nature's Head composting toilet. This is the Bourgeoisien of, I don't know, I'm just being weird. This is very nice. This is top dollar, very nice toilet. I wanted to make sure that my wife was comfortable and everything was clean and I didn't have some freaking 5-gallon bucket with some weird toilet seat adapter on it like I've seen some people do with some weird crank handle. Something you got to stick down in there, like a spoon or something. I've seen some weird stuff on YouTube, but this was the cat's pajamas. So you poop in it, turn this, coconut husk, whatever you want. This is your pee bucket. You pee in the front holes, you poop in the back hole, and that kind of stuff. I'm not going to get in depth, but it is very expensive, but it eliminates the black tank, and that's what I wanted, was to not worry about it. It doesn't stink when you change this. Everyone says that it stinks when you replace this, but that's that. Very nice. I forget what it's called, shower head. Again, this is kind of spotty, but this is the best I could do. It's very simple. This fan right here is a freaking monster. It sucks in a good way. Crack right here, my bad. It and screws that I, it's functional. That's what I was worried about. I wasn't planning on selling this. I was going to keep this for a while, but my work speaks for itself, I guess. Whatever you want to say, you can talk trash, whatever. This is the closet. Some delamination right here. But it's not going to hurt anybody. That is a gas heater that I plugged the gas line off because it was leaking. So I took that out. This right here is a brand new mattress. This is a full short, or a 3/4 mattress. It's not a full short, it's a 3/4 mattress, and I couldn't find a mattress anywhere. So I ended up forking out 600 smackaroonies for this mattress right here from Mattress Insider. My goodness, $600. These numbers are quickly adding up with all the stuff that I put into this. Another LED light. New shroud here, new things, covers for every vent, new wood all in the back here. Actually, I did new wood everywhere. New wood on the sides here, up there, everything was rotted. I had a little bit of wood rot up here, so I replaced this piece and I replaced the cross member that, but everything else checked out pretty good. I'm also replaced the wood in here as well, but everything's good. Everything's solid. I've had it completely sealed up and everything non-leaking for almost a year now. And I've had one issue with this window, but that one's fixed now. So no more leaks. And I also had a leak right here. You can see some little bit of water damage, but not damage, but it's some little residue right here, but it's all good. I have that sealed. Turned out it was the light. I put a new light out there and I didn't seal it up good enough, but everything is good now. Everything's solid. There was no water issues back here except for the windows, of course. So that wood down there needed to be replaced, so I replaced all of it. Oh, let's see, that's your generator, speakers. This is actually your water pump. And let's get to that. I'm not gonna open the back. I'm gonna get down here. I put a huge water tank in it. It is like, I think it's 50, 60 gallons. I don't know, but it is massive. There's the water pump. It's not wired in yet, but there's the, you can probably see how big this water tank is. It's pretty big. It's braced and everything. Let me get a better view of that. You can see it's braced in there. It works pretty good. Got your water hose ran to the inlet and stuff. This is going to be a long video. For y'all that are really interested and that are sticking in, I'm glad you're sticking around. So I put hardwood floors in this. It needs to be cleaned up, of course. I'm trying to think if I'm forgetting anything. You can put a curtain here if you want. I do have some of these replacement, these little tabs right here. I have them in a little Ziploc baggie somewhere. But I haven't tried the stove, but it's just gas and it's, you know, mechanical stove, so it can't be anything too complicated. I'm trying to think. You can see some spotty work here. I've really tried. I'm sorry. That needs to be painted white. I ran a freaking screw through this. It looks horrible, but I have cans of paint, so you could just, you know, I'll throw those in, obviously. It does need some extra more work, but it's more than I can get done before August, because I'm going to be out of town for a month and a half this summer, which was my planned time to get this knocked out, but I can't. Another thing, you got to run some hoses to the sink up there. But I do have the adapter stored away somewhere. I did some insulation there just to be sure that I can live in this in the wintertime. But a lot of, most everything works. If I'm missing anything, y'all please let me know. Here's a list I have. Water pump wiring, shower curtains, plumb the toilet, and referring to the air hoses. Plumb the sink, I just showed you that. Sink cover, that's optional. Carpet, front seats, TV mount, dash completion. There's some wiring that needs to be completed, but I can show you that. Headlights wiring, power steering hoses, brake lines. Now on the rear axle, I have all the brakes completed except for the rear axle. It needs 4 brake lines going to each wheel cylinder on each side. That's easy. I have the hose, the brake lines, and some fittings I can give to you. Bleed finish brakes, front AC. That's the under dash unit I was thinking about. Curtains. I have curtains to throw in. I was going to make my own curtain rods. They're black and they are blackout curtains. I'll throw those in. Those are like $120. Tires. It does need tires. Tank drain. It just needs a hose clamp. Sink pipes. I need a drain pipe to the new tank. It's like right around here. You just got to drill a hole and seal it and then put it on the end where the sink pipe was. Generator plate. I showed you that. Clean the chrome, dash wiring, gauges. Gauges are all done. Trailer hitch, because I was going to tow with this. Electric fan, I showed you that. The cooling fan needs to be wired up. Airbags, I was going to put airbags on the rear axle for towing. I have the seat belts, they just need to be installed. Wire the water heater, which isn't bad. I'll show you that. Radio, I don't know. Boost, I don't know. I was thinking about upping the boost on this, but there's no need. Courtesy lights, you don't need them, but if you want them. Rear marker lights, I showed you that. And align the door. The door kind of pokes out a little bit, so just undo the hinge. And you know, it's small work, but again, I'm a very busy dude. I'm a full-time student and work. As for the water heater wiring, I just haven't done it. It's all ran. You can see the old floor down here, and I know this is kind of dirty, but again, it is a project. These black wires are for the fan for the toilet. This is just a ground and a power wire right here. I was going to put a power wire right here, and I have a fuse block I was going to put back here, so I have fuses for all my accessories, such as this for your water heater and the other water heater down there. But other than that, y'all let me know if there's something I did not cover that you're interested in. The roof is completely redone. I'm not going to try to get up there and show you that. But there's some rot up there. There you go. I didn't show you that, but it's not leaking anymore. That's the main point. I just haven't gotten around that. That's obviously pretty solid. I haven't gotten around to doing all the work, but this is a project. And if y'all have any questions, again, please ask if you're truly interested. Again, I need $10,000 for this. I have money. I look horrible, but I put so much time and money into all of this. I've spent countless hours redoing all this, and from when I first got it, it looked horrible. I don't even know why I bought it. Oh, title situation. Now, that is kind of a situation. The guy I bought it off of did a title bond here in Mississippi, and he completed it wrong. It just, me and him's going to take a trip up there next week. I'm filming this at the end of February. I forget the date. I think it's the 25th. And so next week, we're going to meet up, and we're going to go to the tag office, and we're going to finish out the paperwork, because I tried calling to get it fixed. He tried calling to get it fixed, but it has to take me and him physically going there. And this was all during COVID, so the places were closed for the longest time, so we completely gave up for a while. So we're going to try to get the title. It's not going to be an issue. It's just a time thing. But we can get a title for it. It's easy here in Mississippi. So don't worry about that. Once I do have the title, I will post up an update, and you know, we'll get it going. So we're at 22 minutes right now. So I'm gonna let y'all go. I'm gonna get another look around of the RV, show y'all everything. There you go. It is beautiful. It's a beautiful RV. I'll show y'all the roof too. Thank y'all for bearing with me. If you're still watching, you know that's amazing. You must be truly interested in this. But like I said, I got extra headlights. The rear wiper works. Let's go to the top here. It's a little dirty, but it's all resealed. Cheap out on that. I got a... Man, I forgot what it was called. It's got the bald guy on it. But I got his thermal roof coating, because it gets hot down in Mississippi. And it is an aluminum roof, which it does help reflect, but it still retains heat because it's very thermally conductive metal. So I put that thermal coating on there, got sunburnt like crazy because it reflected right back on my... Anyways, y'all let me know. My phone number is area code 336-415-8023. You can send me a message on Facebook. Tell me you're interested. We can talk about it, see what we got to do. I got to have it gone, but I'm buying another RV this weekend that's finished. I'm not going to get lowball offers. I know how much it's worth. You people should know how much it's worth, how much work, and the diesel motor that's in it. I'll sit on it for 10 years. I'm not moving off of 10 grand. So I love y'all. Thanks for watching.